Hey guys, welcome to my channel. In this video we are going to learn how to set relationship from one table to the other tables. So in this scenario we have a table called, we have a database e-commerce and a table called users with products and orders. Okay, so in this user table there are three registered users and we have few products here. So once the user places some order, so that should go and store in the orders table. So we are storing the user ID and the product ID in the products table, orders table, sorry. So how do you set? So I will show you how to set the user ID in this column and the product ID from the product table, which will be shown here, which the user has placed the order. So let us go to the structure and relation view, and add constraint name will keep foreign key for user ID. Okay, so this will be from the user ID, so from user ID column, from the e-commerce database and users table, and the column will be ID of this table, users table's ID. So let us give on delete restrict and on update, let it be restrict, I'll tell you why. Let us save and check. And yes guys, your query has been successfully executed. You can see here foreign key for user ID is already stored. So let us add one more thing for the product ID also. So relation view will keep your foreign key for product ID. Let us keep, and here let us keep the product ID column from the e-commerce database and products table and the ID of the products table. So let us keep here cascade. I'll tell you why cascade, and let us save it. So yes guys, it has successfully been created. So let us browse. Now just fill in the details here. I will just show you how. User ID, let us say user ID Matthew has this product mobile he has ordered. Go. And again Matthew has ordered t-shirt. Let us insert this value also. And now user ID 2 has ordered the product ID 1. Go. Okay, this much is enough for our tutorial guys. So let us see the order. This has been placed. So we have given for the user as restrict, on delete restrict, it has been given here. You can see it is for the user ID on delete restrict. So in the orders table we see that user ID 1 has ordered product ID 1 and 2. Now if we delete this user ID 1, let us try deleting. Delete, yes, okay, cannot delete user because it is there in the user ID of the this key we had created over there. So how do you overcome this? For the products, if you remember, I'll just show you. For the products we had created on delete cascade. See here, on delete, here it is. See, for the product ID it's on delete cascade and on update cascade. So what happens in the cascade scenario is, I'll show you. Here it is. So if we delete this product number 1, it has been deleted successfully. In the orders it will become, see, the product ID which had 1 in it also got deleted. So I'll show you what happens on this cascade and restrict will not let you to delete like this. Set null, the value will become as empty over there. So that's it guys for this video. Please subscribe, like and share for more videos. Thank you.